Monday, mailbag time. And in the spirit of the holiday season and in the spirit of opening things, I'm going to open this Firehouse Ale from Lake of the Woods Brewing Company. Yes, I'm wandering a little further afield. Lake of the Woods Brewing Company is in Kenora, Ontario. Yeah, that's not that far away, really. It's only about 2 hours down the highway. This they call an English nut brown ale. I'm liking that color. It says they use a chocolate malt, which sounds interesting. What do we got here? The brewery and tap room is located in a century-old fire hall in downtown Kenora. Chocolate malt provides the color and aroma of this amber-colored ale. Firehouse Ale. Oh, I like that. You certainly taste the chocolatiness in the malt. Okay, that's open. Most important thing out of the way. Now then, some stuff. Now let's start with the box today, which says new 10 pieces lithium ion 3.7 volt 18650 battery input output protection board. And then it says it all over again. That's pretty specific. I suppose there is a chance that that's actually what's in this thing. There. Come on, open. Oh. Three things. Cool. Okay. Let's get into thing the first. That doesn't look a thing like a battery protection circuit. Whatever it is, it's actually two of them. There. Get out. Okay. Two boards the same. Let's get in here. Can we focus on you? Close enough. Okay, so what do we have? We have an out in the ground, in the ground, a plus and a minus, a potentiometer, a capacitor, and one little 8-pin IC, which is LM386. I believe that's an op amp, which makes those a little amplifier board of some kind. I know there's a couple of you guys that can read Chinese, so not sure which way up is correct, but if you feel like translating just for fun, that would be cool. But I'm gonna guess these are little amplifier boards with adjustable gain. DC 3 volt to 12 volt LM386 mini audio power amplifier board amp module, 750 milliwatts, 3/4 of a watt. This one came from Elec Module 58. I've spent 99 cents each for two of them, so two of them would be, well, $2, I guess, basically, minus a couple pennies. Free shipping. So what do we got here? Operating voltage 3 to 12. Support power half a watt to 25 watts. What? That's crazy talk. Output impedance between 4 and 32 ohms, so it can drive a speaker or headphones. Output power 750 milliwatts maximum. Do we have specifications? The higher the voltage, the better, up to maximum. Operating, okay, so from the power supply, it'll take up to 150 milliamps. Any powered speaker can be used, but yeah, okay, that's what they're talking about. You can use a big speaker if you want. It won't get any louder, but you could use one. They're suggesting to use it for microphone preamplification. Good low noise AC ripple. Output signal voltage is greater than 1 volt or more. And it has a potentiometer. Nice simple little circuit. Battery. Audio in, audio out. Ta-da. Oh, and they have an advanced version, which I'm not going to bother looking at. All right, next. Oh, these look familiar. These, yeah, okay. More of the, these are what it actually said on the box. 18650 protection boards. These are very similar to the ones that we saw not that long ago. So again, let's zoom back in here. Doink. Oh, it even says 18650. Okay. So we've got a P plus and a P minus and a B minus, which must make that B plus. Oh no, wait a minute. P plus, P minus, unlabeled pad, B minus. Okay. Those are a bit different. And you got two chips on there. Again, one of them is going to be the protection. One of them is going to either be a MOSFET or have a MOSFET in its output. And 10 of those. Okay. New 10 pieces, 1S lithium ion, lithium 3.7 volt, 18650 battery, input output protection board PCB. Again from UEC-module 58. How much did I pay for them? Did I pay one penny plus a dollar ship, dollar and a quarter shipping? Okay, so I guess it cost me $1.26 Canadian for 10 of these, or 12.6 cents each. That's a reasonable price, I guess. Oh, and one bid, which means I got this at auction. Okay. Well, that's cute. So, charging voltage, 5 volt DC input, maximum continuous output, 3 amps, over voltage protection and current protection, and short circuit protection, blah, blah, blah. And the physical connections, B plus, B minus for battery, and P plus, P minus for the circuit. Okay, very similar to those ones we looked at last time. And the third thing that was in that bag. Oh, that's different. It is. So a 4-pin motor is going to be a stepper motor with a long screw shaft on it. So not unlike those ultra tiny steppers that I've had earlier. Hang on, let me just grab one. Yeah, these little stepper motors that I got a while back, I probably shouldn't have zoomed out, should I? They're super tiny. So these ones, 4 wires and a lead screw. This one, also 4 wires and a lead screw. I'm guessing it's, well, with the lead screw, it's going to be torquey as hell anyway. I have to figure out, I guess, how to mount something to it. I'm guessing something that just keys into there, and as it spins, it can drag it along. So what do we got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So let's say 16, just for giggles. So 16 revolutions of the motor is what it'll take for whatever's attached to it to get from there all the way to there, which is a distance, according to my cutting mat, of about 2 inches. So 5 centimeters. That's going to give you some really, really precision positioning. Not sure what I'm going to use it for, but I'm sure I'll find something to do with it. Also from UEC-module 58, the 15 millimeter two-phase four-wire micro step stepper motor with long screw rod stepping motor. I paid $1.24 Canadian. And okay, so 15 millimeter diameter, 58 millimeter long brass screw. What else do we have to say about it down below here? More mechanical stuff. coil resistance 28 ohms. DIY micro laser printer is a good choice. Interesting. You know what they didn't say? What's the voltage of the coil? Okay, that's useful information that will prevent and will save me a step, I guess. I mean, don't need to look up what, don't need to figure out what the pinout is. But I think I probably will anyway, just because I don't trust them. Next in, 3P100, 2.54 millimeters, or meters, or two, something. Oh, okay. A bunch of DuPont cable shell, connector shell things. These are the 3-pin ones. So for making up 3-pin versions of those guys, I think I've gotten some of these in the past and I talked about them. They are for... using with the hang on here, a shield. These breakouts here. This is a nano on a breakout, and each one of these columns of pins this way has ground, 5 volts, and signal all the way along. So if I'm building circuits to attach to them, I can just cable them onto there for ease of connection and disconnection. That's going to be for things like the optical sensors that I'm using on the railroad. And stuff like that there. 100 times 3P DuPont jumper wire cable housing female pin connector 2.54 millimeter pitch. YP. Whatever YP means. Okay, these ones looks like I got at an auction. 63 cents for the 100 of them. That's probably why I bought them, because they were cheaper than just buying them normally. You can always use them. I know I've already got some in stock, but for that price, how can you go wrong? What do we have here? It doesn't say. Gift is all it has to say. Okay. Open. Get out. Bubble pack. Huh? Business cards? Oh, Prox cards. Oh, okay. These are RFID proximity sense cards. I got a couple of different RFID modules way back, and one of them didn't come with any cards to use with it, so I'm hoping that these are the correct ones. I guess we'll see when I go to experiment with them. 5 pieces NFC smart card tag tags, 1KS50IC, 13.56 megahertz. That's important. Read and write RFID Arduino. Bought these from Deep Learnings, and the 5 of them cost me $1.59. What do we have to say down below here? This card is compatible with NFC capable phones and tablets. It is smart card tags. You can do many tasks to use this tag. Set an alarm. If you don't know how to use it, please search YouTube. Many free applications. Okay. So again, runs on 13.56 megahertz. It's PVC. It's waterproof. Distance 0 to 10 centimeters. So it has 1K bytes of electrically erasable programmable read-only memory with 768 free bytes available. So some of it must have a permanent hardware serial number or something. Organized in 16 sectors with 4 blocks of 16 bytes each. Rate endurance, 100,000 cycles. ISO 14443 or 14443A standards. We'll see about that. And keywords for various phones. Okay, that's not what I was expecting. Although it does say Arduino, but it's an NFC. That's different. What do we have here? One module, Chinese variety. I like it when they lie on there. It makes it interesting. It makes it a guessing game. Oh, some kind of LED modules. Well packaged, anyway. And the mailing envelope was bubble type. We have 8 LEDs, 4 resistors, and a micro USB. Let's take the micro USB that's charging that 18650 back there. Plug in one of these and see what happens. Well, that's fairly bright. Well, that's quite bright. If you shine through there. That's kind of cool. What happens if I do that? Ooh, cute. Oh, those are interesting. They don't plug directly into a power bank, which is a little annoying. But, and they've got a screw hole on the back of them. That's kind of clever. So what does... Oh yeah, I'm going to plug this guy back in to keep him charging. Unfortunately, I let it die before and didn't have time to recharge it here. So what do we have here? So these, track there and track there. Actually, I should have plugged. Yeah, hang on. I'll plug one of them in. Use it to backlight the other one. So we can see what the traces are doing. There we go. Okay. So these are in parallel. These are in parallel. This side here is in parallel with that. This side here is one parallel circuit. And this side here is another. So what is the voltage drop against an LED? Right. Okay, so that's just facing the other way, so it's not blinding. And then this is telling me 120 milliamps. Neat little units. I assume I ordered those because why wouldn't you order LED lights? 5 pieces micro USB mobile power lamp, 8 pieces LEDs, board emergency light, SMD 5730. 5730 is the physical description of the actual LEDs themselves. From Robot Home, I got these at auction for $1.88 Canadian or $1.50 American for the 5 of them. I think that's a pretty good deal just for the LEDs themselves. Even if I don't use them with the micro SD connector, or micro USB connector rather, I could still solder 5 volts onto them and use them for something or other. That's interesting. Let's see. Description: USB lights using micro USB interface design. Easy to access ordinary mobile phone. Working voltage 5 volts. Working current 160 to 240 milliamps. Yeah, that's in the range that we saw. Micro USB, half watt LEDs times 8. Total 4 watts for the whole thing. That makes sense. White color, white. Applications. Oh, where can we use them? We can use them in the bedroom, in the wardrobe, in the aisle. In a bookcase. Mobile power, yes. Notebook, netbook, desktop, PC. Components, 5 times 125 kilohertz RFID. Ah. Wonder if these are the same as those other ones that I ordered, or they're different. They're itty bitty dot RFIDs, huh? Those are interesting compared to these ones. Wonder if they're the same type. Apparently there's two different types, or two different general frequencies of RFIDs. These ones say that they're 125 kilohertz, says right on it. The other ones didn't really say what they were for frequency. So I guess I'm going to have to check the list and see what the listing might tell me. So it looks like this seller isn't selling these round RFID tags anymore. Anyways, they called them 5 pieces writable rewrite 125 kilohertz RFID tag key fob for copier access control top. The seller was Mobile Kits, and I bought them for $1.27 for the package of 5 of them. I'm going to guess that I bought it at an auction. And the reason I'm going to guess that I bought it at an auction was because when I search for the keywords, 5 pieces RFID, 125 kilohertz round, and sort by cheapest first, this is the least expensive I can get, $13.77. And it goes up from there. Oh, wait, no, there's some that are $9.37 for 5. But still, that's like orders of magnitude more than I paid for them. So that's what leads me to believe that I actually got these at an auction. And if I did, I got a hell of a deal. I think I'm going to throw one extra one in here. Just, that was 5 that I've done. I'm going to open this one as well, just because it's a holiday. No idea what it is again. Oh. Okay, what are you guys? Those look like... Yes, they are. They're microphones. They're little microphone modules. So I was... Oh. Few people, including Big Clive and Electro Boom, and a few other people, have been playing with microphone projects in the last, a little while, I guess. And I thought maybe I should try and find a cheap way to improve my sound around here. The sound that I'm using is 90% of the time I'm using this phone right here. You're watching what I'm doing using my Samsung Note 4, which is about that far in front of my face right now. So I'm just using its built-in microphone for 90%. When I'm on the computer doing that part of it, I'm using this old PC microphone, which is using one of the selfie stick pieces that as a microphone boom. And it just goes straight into the laptop. And when I'm at the laptop, it is sitting, again, about that far in front of my face. So, it's reasonable sound. I don't know how crap-tacular that microphone is. They sound not too different. I don't have to worry about getting lots of low end out of them. My voice is very low endy anyway. So I think as much as they're picking up is adequate. At least nobody's complained about me sounding thin and anemic. I don't know. That's a bit of a ramble off topic, but that's what these guys are. I think if I remember from when I ordered them, they're Electret microphones, which makes them basically a variable capacitor, and the noise coming in them vibrates the two plates in relation to each other. There's a little circuit inside it that deals with that and amplifies it a little bit. The two pins are ground and the audio coming out, but also a DC voltage going in to power the little circuit and charge the plates of the capacitor. More on that when I finally get around to actually doing it. In the meantime, check the listing. And finally, 5 pieces of 6x5mm 52D sensitivity capacitive electret microphone, new ICV. From Wichita Star? Okay, yeah, that's what it says down there, Wichita Star. Okay, I paid $1.24 Canadian or 99 American pennies for the 5 of these. And they're basically just electret microphones. Doesn't say anything further about them down here. And there's this episode's Mailbag Monday haul. As I mentioned before, these Mailbag Monday series that I've been doing every Monday since late November was only intended to be for the last part of the year through the holidays. Now that we're back into 2018, I think I'm going to keep doing my mailbags on Mondays, but I'm not going to do it every Monday. Partly because I'm going to go broke if I do 4 or 5 things every week for a year. And partly because I want to keep it interesting. I don't want to say, hey, look, guys, it's a bag of screws. Because that's going to get boring real quick. And try and keep it interesting with different and varied stuff. If you have any comments, please put them down below. Complaints, tell me what I did wrong. Several of you have corrected me on things, which is going to help me a lot when I go to actually use some of these modules. One guy corrected me on how these things connect, and I'm going to have to dig into them a bit more before I hook one up and blow it up, or even more amusingly, blow up a lithium battery. The upshoot of all this is, next Monday, there's probably not going to be a Mailbag Monday. I'm going to go to probably 1 every 3 weeks, maybe once a month, depending on how fast stuff comes in. Let me know what you think. If there's anything you'd like to see in a mailbag, and I haven't said this before, I don't think. If there's anything you want to see in a mailbag, requests are taken at my Patreon page. You don't have to request anything. I'm going to keep doing this regardless. You don't have to give me money to do mailbags. I'm going to keep doing them anyway. But if you want me to specifically buy something, toss a couple of bucks in the tip jar, and we'll go from there. Otherwise, I hope you keep enjoying these, and I will talk to you later.